Good morning. My name is Chris Segar, and I am here to give my testimony that I want to begin to tell you a little about myself. I was raised with my mother and three sisters. I grew up in the Catholic faith. I come from a divorced family. And through my journey in life, I had two children, and my daughter Jessica Faber attends this church. And it was through her that she invited me to attend Rejoice in December of 2014. And prior to that, I have come down to church with her. I'm from Webster City, and I have attended church with her before a few times. And when she invited me to come to Rejoice, I accepted that invitation, as well as she invited her new stepmother, Leanne. So we met at Jessica's, and she drove us to Rejoice, and we had a beautiful supper. The ceremony was so empowering and uplifting for me. I was welcomed. I felt such love and acceptance in this church, and felt like I wanted to be a part of this, but wasn't sure yet how that would go. So I listened and attended this supper and heard the Christian woman give testimony to how they found their way, their faith to Jesus Christ and their journey with our Lord. And afterwards, we had I had met Donna Kimberly at dinner, Jessica's friend who she invited to join us. And she talked to us through the service and through the dinner. And then we went home, and Jessica was driving, and Leanne was in the front seat, and I sat in the back seat. And Leanne was attacking Jessica and asking her all kinds of questions about her faith and her belief. And as I sat in the back seat, I heard my daughter quoting scriptures and speaking of the Bible and the Holy Spirit and giving the good news and speaking the truth about God's gospel. Yes, praise Lord. And Leanne did not hear the message. She was still closed-minded to that. But my heart was open, and I did hear that message. And when I got home, I prayed to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to please forgive me of my sins, and to I repented and asked for forgiveness and to be saved. And I know my belief is that Jesus Christ lived, died, and rose again from the dead for my sins to be forgiven so that I could have eternal life. I know that my whole heart and body, my Lord and Savior is with me now. I will live the rest of my days for Him. Amen. And I leave you with this. For those that are wondering how to do and become a follower of Jesus Christ and be saved, it's Luke 1:37. For God, nothing shall be impossible. Praise God.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. So you were hearing the gospel through your daughter secondhand in the back seat.
Yes.
And God was working in your heart, even though it wasn't even, you weren't even a part of the conversation, but God was having a conversation with you, wasn't
Absolutely.
He?
I could hear Him. I knew that was God speaking to me. I think people probably think I'm crazy, but I know I heard Him. I He's with me every day of my life.
Yeah.
I have such comfort and joy. I'm reading my Bible. I'm praying daily. I mean, my life has changed.
Wow.
For the better.
Amen. 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 Well, let me pray for you, Chris, and then we'll baptize you and identify with Christ what He's already done for you. God, we thank you for Chris's story. We thank you that you brought people into her life to invite her to an event. We thank you for this church where she was welcomed and received with joy. We thank you for her daughter who knows your word and was sharing that. And God, we thank you that through your word, you were speaking right to Chris's heart, showing her need for you and for salvation that comes through you alone, through your death in her place and your resurrection, conquering sin and death. And we stand here now in these waters as a changed woman here next to me, a woman that now is confident in who you are and who she is in light of you and the salvation that she's received through grace alone, and a changed life that desires to be in your word, that wants to proclaim you and has true joy. And so God, we pray that that would continue and others would see that and would come to know you as a result. In Jesus' name we ask these things, amen.
Amen.
All right, let's step down here. Chris, upon your public profession of faith and obedience to God's word,
I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.